I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
On the phone with us all the way from Bolton in the United Kingdom, boxing trainer Joe Goossen. Joe, how are you feeling? It's night in LA. I'm sure it's day in the UK.
Well, yeah, we're 8 hours ahead of you right now, and it's about, let's see, it's 11, about 11:15 there, and it's 7:15 in the morning here. So my voice might be a couple octaves lower because I really haven't slept much. I'm still trying to get used to the time change, but I'm not very good at it, you know, so.
All right. So yeah. Good morning. Wanted to talk to you about a fighter you're very familiar with. You trained him before he turned pro. You're big on him. You always said nothing but nice things about him. Boxing star Ryan Garcia. Did you happen to see his fight against Carlos Morales? And you're very familiar with both fighters because you yourself as a trainer faced Carlos Morales. And your fighter Dardan had a lot of success against him. So yeah. Joe, what did you make from the Ryan Garcia fight against Carlos Morales?
You know, I thought I'll start off with Carlos Morales. He, I thought he came very well prepared for the fight, to tell you the truth. And if you noticed, he had a real qualified. You know, he was a great fighter in his day, Rudy Hernandez.
Yeah.
And you know, Rudy's a good strategist, and he knows the type of shape he's. Is that your dog in the background?
Yeah, it's my dog. Yeah, she's in charge of security for the premises, and she's just doing her job. But, yeah, I can hear you.
Well, yeah, but I hear both of you.
Ah, she's far away. So, that's a big bark.
Yeah, listen, look, I mean, we got three on the interview instead of two. That's all right. As I was saying, you know, I think Morales was well prepared by Rudy Hernandez. He's a good strategist, and he was an excellent fighter as well. And it looked like he had Morales in really good shape for this fight. And he had a good strategy. You know, as much as he could get away with the strategy that Morales was employing, you know, because Garcia, you know, in the first half of the fight, kind of dictated the pace, even though Morales was always on the march and he was getting closer and closer with his punches and landed, you know, a number of them in the first half of the fight. But I thought he was outpunched by Garcia the first half of the fight for sure.
A lot of people, Joe, have been telling me that they thought Ryan lost. I disagreed. I thought Ryan won. It was a close fight. What do you think Ryan should do at this point? I mean, just being a person that's familiar with him.
Well, you know, I kind of gave a little breakdown of what I thought of, you know, Morales. And, you know, conversely, I do believe in Ryan Garcia. Look, he just turned 20 years old. He was in a rough 10-round fight. That's a lot to ask. I mean, you know, if I go back to, you know, a few years back, we used to kind of, even when a guy had 14, 15, 16 fights, they weren't really fighting 10-rounders necessarily. You know, you had a lot of 4-rounders, a lot of 6-rounders. You worked your way into this. You know, and I'll just take the Relis boys as an example. You know, they both had close to 60 fights in their career. In the first 2 years, you know, they had lots of 4-rounders and 6-rounders. And 8-rounders before they graduated to 10-rounders. So that's something to be said there. It's a little bit of a rush job nowadays. They kind of throw you in the deep end a little bit sooner than we used to. You'd get a lot more experience. And by the time you hit the 10-rounders, you know, you kind of look like a main event fighter. Now, Ryan has all the possibilities in the world. I think he's got great potential, and I think he's going to live up to that potential eventually. And each fight is a learning experience. Look, I think he won the fight for sure. I don't have any doubt about that. I think that Morales came on in the end and gave him a run for his money, but I think Ryan proved his mettle. You know, he stayed with it as much as he can. He got a little bit tired in the second half of the fight. But, you know, there's reasons why that happens. You know, I don't know exactly how he trained. I'm sure he trained hard. He's a hard worker. He's been working hard since he's been a kid. You know, he's got some big victories in the amateurs over some really good pros right now, one of them being Devin Haney. You know, he beat him three times in the amateurs. Devin's is an undefeated fighter as well. Now, that being said, you know, I would say, yeah, are there some things you could pick out that Ryan could have done better? Absolutely. He relies on that left hook a lot, you know, as a single shot punch that, you know, he expects to do a lot of damage. And I think Morales was kind of nullifying that left hook of his, which is really his best weapon. He kept his hands up real well, Morales did, and he did a lot of standing and squatting. He was he kept his head in different positions. He didn't come in just straight in. I think a couple of the faults, if you want me to pick some out, and it's something that I talked to Ryan with when he was an amateur, that eventually as a pro, you're going to have to figure out. You're going to have to figure out the inside game. And I got to tell you, in the early rounds, Ryan probably hurt Morales the most with the punches that were inside. In other words, he landed a couple of short right hands that I thought stunned Morales, even though Morales was in good shape and came back. But I thought there was way too much clinching, you know. I thought that Ryan could have worked the body a little bit more. Now, that, you know, when you do that, when you go to the body, you put yourself in harm's way a little bit more. But if you learn how to do it, it can be very effective, and it can really do damage to the guy in front of you. If you're continually head hunting, guys just keep their hands up real well. And, you know, a smart guy like Morales did that.
Be more false.
So, if the head isn't open, you got to go to the body.
Again, he just turned 20.
I thought he could have used maybe a variety of punches.
He's got a long square
ahead of him. But I thought in the first four or five rounds,
even with the deficiencies,
he was pressuring Morales. He was landing long shots. The
those
right
things
hand of
can
the
be
body.
Cured. Okay.
He worked the jab pretty well. He landed
that.
Some.
He
he's
going to be
hurt
right
a lot of
handled.
People that were I thought
and,
effective.
And guess what?
But again,
some guys take a while to mature to have their full power.
He's
going to
need more experience.
Again, he's he just turned 20 the other night.
He's going to learn along the way.
Sometimes you learn in the fight more than you do in the gym.
Full-fledged
you can have
men.
One fight,
and
that'll teach you more than
a man.
You know,
but
three,
some
four
guys
months
don't
in the
get
gym
that
real
spark,
good
you
man
that.
Strength.
And
until
and
the 21,
23,
you know what I mean. Sometimes
and
it's 23.
He won the fight in my eyes. Okay, he got a little tired in the second half of the fight. Self-admittedly, in his post-fight interview, he was being honest there, and he gave props to Morales. But I just think that at this point, he's got to start switching to more of a professional style. He still boxes like he did, you know, I don't want to say as an amateur, but as an early pro. You should be able to see the progression in your pro career where you're doing more things than you did in your last fight. And I think Morales was the guy to do it with, because Morales only has 6 knockouts. He could have taken more chances with him. He could have sat in the pocket with him a little bit. Not that you have to sit there and exchange and get hit. You know, he could have delivered. He's so fast. I think he could have worked the body, some left uppercuts, short right hands. He could have weaved a little bit more. I know his corner was calling for him to move his head and to do more slipping. Now, when you do that, when you move your head and you slip more, that means you're slipping punches that are in closer range to you. And when you slip, you're supposed to counter wherever it might be, normally to the body when you slip. So, I mean, those are the things that his trainer was calling for, but he was having a hard time getting to it, whether it was a reluctance to do it or he didn't feel comfortable doing it. That's another story I can't answer for you. But I still say, in spite of all the deficiencies, or I should say the lack of experience, and him trying to, you know, get to more body shots and a little bit more inside fighting, I think that will come eventually. It wasn't evident in this fight, though, and I think that kind of hurt him a little bit. I think He could have maybe put a bigger hurt on Morales had he fought him on the inside a little bit more for those few seconds that you get inside. Take a couple of good shots in there. And if your defense is tight, you'll be okay. It's pretty safe on the inside once you get to know it. You know, once you get experience on the inside, it's pretty safe in there. And you can do a lot of damage in close. So he's got to add that to his game. He's got the outside game down pretty well. But where they were, and I would say where they were maybe clinching or holding a little bit too much, and it was coincidental on both parts. But I think Ryan, instead of, you know, maybe grabbing around the neck or wrapping him up, he could have taken that time to just relax, put your hands up good, sit down a little bit more, turn them a little bit more on the inside and work the body, work shorter shots. And if you trust your defense, you can get away with that. And I think that will come eventually. He's got to learn it. He's got to spend more time at the gym working on it. And if he does, he'll add a whole new dimension to his style. And this is what it's going to take. I got to tell you, you know, he reminds me a lot of Oscar De La Hoya when he was young. Although Oscar at a very early age was an excellent body puncher. And he could work on the inside. He could bump and grind on the inside. He wasn't much of a holder. And he would do well, I think, Ryan, to look at some of Oscar's earlier fights. Because Oscar could beat you on the inside or outside. But I think that if I'm going to critique Ryan at all, it's just he's got to get a few new dimensions to his game. And then he'll be really, really hard to beat. And I think he'll take out guys like Morales. Now, Morales, you know, I thought was in excellent shape because he poured it on in the end. He was working hard just like Ryan was in the first half of the fight. But in the second half of the fight, Morales was still pretty fresh. And it showed because he came on, you know, 8, 9, and 10. And, you know, and by Ryan's own admission, he thought the fight was closer than the judges had it. And that might be true. I still thought he won it. But, yeah, Morales made a good account for himself, accounting of himself by coming on strong in the end. And you got to give him credit for that. And that was something that gave Ryan a few problems. He got a little tired, and the other guy was coming on. So, but I like I said, I think he piled up enough points through the first half and some of the rounds in the second half. But, you know, this kid has got a lot on the ball. He's got, number one, he's got charisma in the ring. Number two, he's got extremely fast hands, but he's got to put them to better use. And get a better variety of punches and take a few more chances. He's got to sit in the pocket a little bit more when he gets there. As you saw, Morales forced him on the inside. And like I was told a long time ago by a trainer when I had a really good boxer named Michael Nunn, who really liked to stay on the outside at arm's length. You know, it wasn't a trainer. It was a fighter who told me, he said, Joe, one day somebody's going to make Mike Nunn fight on the inside, whether he likes it or not. And it really rang true with me, and it was kind of at that point I really made more of a concerted effort to get Nunn to be more capable on the inside. And let me tell you, it really paid off because midway through his career and towards the height of his career with me, he was devastating guys on the inside. I mean, he stopped when he won the world title. He beat the gold medal winner and the world champion at the time, Frank Tate, with a body shot to the liver, and that really put the kibosh on Tate. And then he stopped him in the next round with a flurry, you know. So it really would serve him well, because some guys are going to force you to fight him on the inside. As the more he steps up in class. And you got to be ready for that. You got to be able to defend yourself on the inside or outside. And I think that day will come for Ryan. He's just got to start looking towards that right now and add that new dimension to his style. And then he can be a double threat. Right now, he's just a threat from the outside. Now, when Ryan worked at my gym, he would spar with several very good boxers and punchers. And, you know, he used to work that upper shot so well, and it was so infrequent in this fight, you know. He could have gone from that hook to the left uppercut, back to the liver, and, you know, he was really just throwing that one hook most of the night. And his right hands were, you know, like I say, when he landed them, they were solid. But just, I think, just too far and few between. So, and then again, like I say, I don't know. I'm sure his trainers were working him hard. I don't know what another man's doing when I'm not there. But if he did give it his all, you know, in terms of training, then he's got to look to find out why he got a little tired in the second half of the fight.
Joe, I got to ask you this. You've been a believer in him from day one. A lot of people were big on him, then a lot of people backed off, then they're back on, then they're back off. Boxing is like that. You've been consistent by saying, Elie, this kid is talented. This kid is going to be a champion. He's crazy talented. Why do you think so many people are jumping on and off the Ryan Garcia bandwagon?
Well, there's a few reasons. You know, I mean, look. You have a lot of fans behind you, and there's a lot of talk at just how great you are, and including myself, you know, I've said many times, and truthfully speaking, that I think this kid is going to be a great champion one day. You know, there's a lot of expectations. See, when you have a lot of people that, you know, De La Hoya signed him, they pumped him up a lot. They gave him a lot of fights, and they put a lot of publicity on him. And quite frankly, they spent a lot of money on him. And so, you know, a lot is expected of him. So, what happens is when you don't exactly fulfill everyone's expectations, they start, finding reasons why, be more fault with you, you know.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, at Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Elie Seckbach.